Duke of Sussex's legal action against Sun and Daily Mirror over alleged phone hacking takes attack on press up level. Prince Harry's move to take legal action against tabloids for alleged phone hacking is part of the royals' ramped-up aggressive PR approach designed to send a message to the media, according to commentators. It emerged on Friday night that the Duke of Sussex, who released a strongly worded attack on the British media for their treatment of his wife, Meghan, earlier this week, has issued legal proceedings against the owners of The Sun and The Daily Mirror. Buckingham Palace confirmed claims had been filed at the High Court regarding alleged illegal interception of voicemail messages. It comes after a separate legal action was launched by the Duchess against the Mail on Sunday for alleged breach of privacy and copyright infringement over the newspaper's decision to publish a private letter she sent to her estranged father. It is not known precisely which period the alleged hacking relates to, although it is likely to be historical. It is understood there is a 6-year limit on claims, which begins when the claimant first learns about the offense. A source with knowledge of the case said it was part of the round of phone hacking claims being put together by solicitors for this autumn. Newspaper groups will now be required to provide any evidence that indicates Harry could have been a victim. The lengthy legal process means any potential trial involving Harry would be unlikely to take place before October 2020. Court listings show he has issued 2 claims, one against News Group, which published the News of the World until its closure, as well as The Sun, and the second against Mirror Group Newspapers, which owns The Daily Mirror and Sunday Mirror. Experts said the Prince's attempts to take on elements of Fleet Street risked backfiring. The PR specialist Mark Borkowski said Harry was backing himself into a corner with the media. "I think this was a very tactical ploy yesterday," he said of the latest legal action. "What he's hoping, what he's demonstrating is, you want to take me on, mate. I'm a different breed to other people, I'm a fighter, I'm not going to play to any rules and I'm going to come and get you." Either he's buying time, or sending a message and trying to frighten newspaper proprietors who are deeply scared of Lepzin, the inquiry into press ethics. "It's a really, really dangerous game. You're going to make a lot of lawyers rich, they'll be rubbing their hands from both sides. It's definitely a tactic to put the frighteners on people. It's definitely a tactic to say, I'm a different type of royal, come for me if you will, a different tactic in the sense, I'm going to protect my wife whatever happens. If you're going to get a story about me, you're going to have to make sure it's absolutely robust." Ingrid Seward, the editor-in-chief of Majesty magazine and a royal biographer, said, "Harry seems to be conducting an all-out war with some parts of the media, which can be difficult. Even if he wins both cases, which I'm sure he'll win the phone hacking, I simply don't understand, why now? Probably Harry's just had enough and he's not going to sit back and take the flak anymore, and this is his way of flexing his royal muscles." In his statement released during the royal couple's tour of South Africa, Harry accused parts of the media of waging campaigns against individuals with no thought to the consequences. He added, "Though, my action may not be the safe one, it is the right one. I've seen what happens when someone I love is commoditized to the point that they are no longer treated or seen as a real person. I lost my mother and now I watch my wife falling victim to the same powerful forces." Seward said, "That was a very personal and angry and inflamed attack. I don't think it achieved anything apart from detract from the success of their South African tour. That was far too vitriolic and personal. He has the right to compare himself to his mother if he wishes to, but his mother's situation was very different." Seward said she suspected Prince Harry's stand against the media was being urged by his wife. "Americans are historically extremely litigious and it's their way of dealing with things. We do it differently, especially members of the royal family who historically have very seldomly sued because it's just more attention on them. And it drags up dirty washing. Harry is very volatile. He doesn't always think the consequences of his actions through. So far, certainly in the first instance, in releasing the statement, the consequence of his actions have been very derogatory and negative." Asked what her advice would be to the prince in dealing with the press, she said, "I'd say, take a leaf out of his mother's book and make friends with your enemies. If Diana didn't like something somebody had written, she would get on to them. Certainly I've experienced that." Then she'd have them round to KP, Kensington Palace, then their putty in her hands. But Harry is certainly not going to do that. The costs of dealing with historical phone hacking claims, many of them relating to stories published 15 years ago when the British tabloid industry was far more popular and financially successful, now weigh heavily on the already struggling finances of publishers of The Sun and The Mirror, as they deal with payouts and lawyers' fees costing tens of millions of pounds. Prince Harry is suing two British tabloid newspapers, accusing them of hacking his phone and stealing voice messages. The claims against the Daily Mirror and The Sun were filed in the High Court of Justice on Harry's behalf and involve illegal interception of voicemail messages, Buckingham Palace confirmed on Saturday to the Associated Press. The announcement comes 4 days after Harry's American wife Meghan Markle filed a claim against the Mail on Sunday and its parent company Associated Newspapers, alleging the intrusive and unlawful publication of a private letter written by the Duchess of Sussex. The Guardian reported that the letter was penned by Markle to her estranged father. Meghan Markle sues British tabloid, Prince Harry speaks out, "My deepest fear is history repeating itself." The Sun is owned by News Group Newspapers, a subsidiary of News Group, which is a sister company of Fox Corporation, which owns Fox News Group. The newspaper acknowledged Harry's legal action. Reach PLC, which owns the Daily Mirror, said it was aware that proceedings have been issued but hasn't yet received notice of them. Meghan Markle using Africa Tour to repair tarnished reputation, report. On Tuesday, Harry issued a statement condemning the British tabloid press for running a ruthless campaign against his wife that has escalated over the past year. "Up to now, we have been unable to correct the continual misrepresentations, something that these select media outlets have been aware of and have therefore exploited on a daily and sometimes hourly basis," Harry noted. The prince also said his deepest fear is history repeating itself. "I've seen what happens when someone I love is commoditized to the point that they are no longer treated or seen as a real person. I lost my mother and now I watch my wife falling victim to the same powerful forces," he said in a reference to his mother, Princess Diana, who died in a 1997 car crash while trying to elude paparazzi in Paris. A timeline of the royal family's most infamous feuds. British tabloid newspapers have paid millions of dollars to settle claims that their employees had hacked the phone voicemails of celebrities, politicians and others in the public eye. Harry and William have long had a strained relationship with the press. They grew up in the spotlight and were young boys when their parents' acrimonious divorce received wall-to-wall coverage.